Hello, Commander. Which one? Let me guide you. Hello, Commander. What is it you need? That resource is abundant on Titan. You can extract it from the atmosphere by building a steam cracker. Otherwise, try exploring. My sensors were picking up a spectrum anomaly earlier near the space elevator platform. Oh, hello, Commander. I have noted some possible improvements in your mission log. Hello, Commander. Very well. What do you want to argue about? Negotiation simulation complete. Are you satisfied with your training? Of course you didn't. I'm not human. What is it you need? Construction complete.
What can I do for you? Tell me. Nobody? Did you check the surroundings? Keep trying. We need to know what happened. What can I do for you? Tell me. Well, what's on it? What? Are you sure? How? What the f? I'll check the systems. Everything checks out. Maybe it was Karen. I'd rather not. Can you confront her about it? I have to live with her here, and I don't need her death stares to get any worse than they already are. Falsely accusing her will not help matters. I mean, maybe we got hacked or something. 100% sure it's a manual override. Please ask Karen. What can I do for you? Yes? I know. Units of three, right? Karen and I are the skeleton crew of Chrono Station. Well, Val was here months before you arrived, so that was our team up here. Will was down there getting things ready for you, but when he died, we had to improvise. Now, don't take this the wrong way, but I was disappointed when it was just you coming in from the Hesiod. I know they can't just teleport people in from Earth, but they could have done more. Yeah, he was the first one down there. No sense in risking more than one neck on the first try. You don't know about William? What the fuck did they tell you in briefing? Well, don't believe everything you hear. Anyway, Billy killed himself after he heard about his wife and kids. Left a suicide note on his log. I told Karen not to tell him about it until he was back up here, but she insisted. No empathy, that woman. We didn't get any information on the cause of death, but I suspect they're casualties of the food riots I've been hearing about. Yeah, things were bad when I left Earth, but there was still a glimmer of hope. By the time you boarded the Hesiod, things must have been way worse. And that was years ago. Who could still be crazy enough to buy into the whole salvation narrative that IASA is selling us? The world has truly gone to shit, and sometimes I think we're just making things worse. That's what I want you to find out. Like I said, he probably killed himself. He left the outpost, started walking west until our cameras couldn't track him, and never returned. I'll forward you a suicide note. You know what it's like to be down there. Maybe you can find a clue about where his body is. Good. He took something important with him when he left. When you do find his body, don't report it to Karen. Report it directly to me. I tried putting this on the mission roster, but Karen disapproved. That hasn't changed.
It's not crucial to the mission.
You can hear her say it, can't you? What can I do for you? Yes? Don't jump to conclusions. I hope Val is still alive. Yes? What can I do for you?
Karen isn't on comms duty for another 6 hours. She's probably asleep. Want me to wake her up? She's gonna be pissed.
Thank you.
What can I do for you? What can I do for you?
Commander. Wait, I can hear you. I run a full diagnostic on my communications. Let's get to work. Commander. No, there's nothing we can do for the time being. Commander. All I know is they're coming back after visiting the inner Saturnian system. Commander. The outpost only meets the bare minimum criteria for habitability. We need to work on that. It was not unexpected. We knew the outpost was behind schedule. The life support test returned positive, so descent was greenlit anyway. It's not just my orders. Survival of mankind is at stake here. Forgive me if I'm less concerned about individuals. No, we could not have. The freighter schedule is tied to demand back on Earth. For everyone we miss, people die. I don't believe my life is more valuable than someone else's, no matter where I am. Self-sustainability, improved living conditions, more tanks and drones. IPUMS should have a list of things you can do. Coordinate improvements with the base computer if you're not already doing that. The first thing you need, though, is more power. I happen to know where you can get some more plutonium for the RTG. A few months before launch, a shipment went off course due to unexpected wind gusts. It landed in direct vicinity of the outpost, in a series of dry methane riverbeds to the west. The rover won't be able to navigate that terrain. You probably won't make it on foot. No, I've come up with a better plan. The construction bot is small and nimble enough to navigate there. You can control it manually through the construction station, but you have to override its perimeter limit somehow. Commander. Yes, make it quick. No, not until we figure out what went wrong. Besides, we have no one to replace her. It would take weeks to train someone on board a Hazard. I'm afraid you're stuck on your own for the time being. We are well aware of that. There's nothing we can do right now. Yes, make it quick. Commander. No, there's nothing we can do for the time being. Commander. Karl's shift starts in 10 hours. He's probably asleep. Do you anything else? No.
Hello, Commander. What is it you need? You can find the necessary resources by exploring, or you can try processing items that I'm sorry I didn't meet your expectations. I don't have access. No. 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 Thank you.
Thank you.
Construction complete.
Commander. Yes, make it quick. Commander, Karl's shift starts in 2 hours. He's probably asleep. Anything else? Yes. Commander. Commander. Very well. I'll get him for you.
Okay, here I am. This had better be good. Poor Will. I can only imagine what it must feel like to die like that.
Good.
I know what's on it, and it's better left encrypted. You've done me a favor. It's time you learned the truth. Yes, the truth. You see, Val is alive and well, and I've known all along. By now you may have learned that IASA is not to be trusted. We're working on a secret project to undermine them, because this mission will condemn Earth. You know what? Val can tell you all about this. She's in a cave north of where the lander crashed. I'll let her know you're coming. She'll open the entry for you.
Commander. No, there's nothing.
What can I do for you?
Nope, nothing yet.
What can I do for you? Well, I've got another exploration mission for you. Aerofluctus, flow terrain with meandering hydrocarbon streams. Ought to be breathtaking. It's not a high priority mission, but you will probably find useful minerals there. Take a picture for me, will you?
Yes?
Don't jump to conclusions.
Yes?
What can I do for you? Tell me. I heard. No news on that yet. The audio is an analog signal superimposed on the data stream. Whoever did that didn't intend to mute your conversation, but was trying to piggyback some code. But we haven't found anything yet. No trace, nothing. What can I do for you?
Yes?
What can I do for you?
Karen isn't on comms duty for another 11 hours.
Thank you.
What can I do for you? What can I do for you? What can I do for you?
Commander. Yes, make it quick. No, not until we figure out what went wrong. Besides, we have no one to replace her. It would take weeks to train someone on board a Hazard. Yes, make it quick. Commander. We are speaking in private. Karl wouldn't dare to eavesdrop on my communications. So, you know about that. I'm on the orders not to talk about it, but since you already know, William committed suicide, and I very much fear that it's my fault. I'm the one who told him about his family's demise. It was. I shouldn't have told him. He had a job to do. That's a little suspect. He's been acting very strange since the crash. I don't know. You should probably look into it and report back to me. Commander, we are speaking in private. Commander. We are speaking in private. Karl. Commander. Karl's shift starts in 7 hours. Is anything else? Yes, make it quick. I'm Karen Owens. I'm in charge of Krona Station. OCS in Pretoria, with flying colors. If you want personal information, forget it. Yes, make it quick.
Thank you. What do you want to know? No, I damn nearly died myself. The plan was to fake my death after a couple of days in the outpost, but I guess I fucked up on entry. I made sure you were safe for what it's worth. No, that thing just opened the hatch for us. It can't very well get inside the lander, can it? I switched on your suit, unclasped your seat, and shoved you out. Before I tell you more, I need to know whose side you're on. I'm with Ecofront. We think that the last thing Earth needs is more methane. If we take away the third law of ecology, that all resources are finite and that there is a limit to growing systems, Earth as we know it will cease to be. Ecological interdependence dictates that. I'm here to protect that law, to protect Earth. We thought about it, but I sort of like you. As for taking over, Karen could disable all the systems remotely, and even if we managed to circumvent that, IASA would be sending a task force to get rid of us as soon as they could. If they divert resources from Jupiter, they could be here within the year. It would be suicide, and a pointless one at that. They would just wipe us out and start over. We need secrecy. Guerrilla tactics are our only hope of saving Earth. Ask. That's a lot of questions. I got this pod here by reprogramming the construction bot to build it a few weeks before we landed. That's the reason the first hydro pump wasn't finished in time, and the reason why the outpost was barely operational. It should have all been done weeks ago. Nobody noticed. All I had to do when I got here was connect this pipe to the thermal vent in the back and extend it down as far as it could go. It was a risk, because I had to assemble all of this within a day before my suit and the external battery here ran out. We weren't even sure if the vent would provide enough heat. Well, actually, Karl wasn't sure. I always knew. I trust in nature to provide what I need, even here on Titan. As you can see, it did, it still does, and I'm alive and well. That is liquid water on that ice sheet, by the way. All the ammonia keeps it in a liquid state, even in this cold. Ask. Before you arrived a few weeks ago, before we went through the final training routines together, I was in charge of surveying the surroundings from orbit. I reported the prospector bot as lost, but it wasn't. It was right here all along, doing my personal research. Ask. IASA is not nearly as effective as the Chinese Space Agency, but they're not that incompetent. The outpost was supposed to be a little more feature complete by the time we got there. I've been sabotaging this operation for some time now. Ask. For now, silence. Let me do my job, and I'll let you run the outpost as you see fit. My only concern is hydrocarbons not making it to Earth. If I know I can trust you, we may decide to call upon you later. Maybe later. I have work to do here.